हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ डॉक्टर शशि अग्रवाल। आई वेलकम यू ऑल। टुडे आवर सब्जेक्ट इज़ माइक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स और प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स एंड द टॉपिक इज़ क्वाइट सिग्निफिकेंट। हियर वी आर गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड कंज्यूमर्स इक्विलिब्रियम अंडर यूटिलिटी अप्रोच। In this topic, we are going to cover what is the meaning of consumer equilibrium, what are the assumptions, how we could determine the consumer equilibrium in different situation, then the criticism. It's written out there, available at my blog. Even this lecture is also available in English notes plus Hindi, and it's also available in Hindi notes plus Hindi explanation at my second channel, that is the Shashi Agarwal Economics and Law Classes. First of all, we will understand what is the meaning of consumer equilibrium. It refers to a situation where a consumer gets maximum satisfaction out of his limited income. His income is limited, objective is to get the maximum satisfaction, and when he is getting the maximum satisfaction, so he doesn't want to make any changes in his existing behavior. According to Tiber Saitovetsky, a consumer is in equilibrium when he regards his actual behavior as the best possible under the circumstances, and he feels no urge to change his behavior as long as the circumstances remains unchanged. So we say consumer is in equilibrium. Here again, the consumer is in equilibrium like the bird is in balanced position. He says, I'm in equilibrium as long as I'm getting the maximum satisfaction and I don't want to change. So what are the assumptions of the consumer equilibrium? Consumer is rational. Rational means he is always, when he is going to spend the money, he doesn't spend it impulsive way. He always compares the marginal utility of one commodity with the marginal utility of another commodity. Consumer is rational, consumer is wise, and the objective is to get the maximum satisfaction. And here we are going to assume cardinal measurement of utility. The utility which he derives from the consumption of the commodity could be measured in cardinal numbers like 1, 2, 3. Marginal utility of money remains constant, and there is fixed income and fixed price. There is no change in taste, habits and fashion, and there is independent utility. The utility derived by X commodity is not influenced by the utility derived by the Y commodity. Tastes are constant and the consumer is having perfect knowledge regarding the different commodity and the different prices. So how we could determine? Consumer equilibrium could be determined in different ways. There are three situations: single commodity with one use, a single commodity having many uses, and many commodities, several commodities. So single commodity with single use. Here he is purchasing single commodity which is having one use only. When a consumer buys a commodity, he pays price for it. For each unit of the commodity, he pays the price for it. When we pay the price, we sacrifice. And the marginal utility of money remains constant. When a consumer is purchasing a commodity which is having one use only, he will be in equilibrium position at a point where the marginal utility of the commodity is equal to the marginal utility of money in terms of the price. Because when we are purchasing something, we are getting utility from it. When we are paying the price, it means we are sacrificing the utility. So utility gained is equal to utility sacrificed. Consumer will be in equilibrium when he consumes the quantity at which the price is equal to the marginal utility derived from that unit of the commodity. Here we are going to explain with the help of table, like the consumer, how much cup of ice cream he should buy. Here we could explain with the help of this table, like consumer's equilibrium when he's having single commodity with single use, like when he, like the utility of price which is constant. So he pays rupees 1 for each cup of ice cream, and the utility which he sacrifices, that is 20, because the marginality of money remains constant. So here, when he buys one cup of ice cream, he is getting utility 50, which is more than the sacrifice. And in the second unit, he gets the utility 40, which is more than the utility sacrifice. In third, again, he gets the more than the sacrifice. At the fourth unit, the marginal utility is 20 and the sacrifice is also 20. So here, he is not driving any surplus, he's in equilibrium. So he will buy the four units of the ice cream. Because at the fourth unit, the marginal utility becomes equal to the price. Because if he buys the fifth unit, the utility gain will be less and the sacrifice will be more. Now we could depict single commodity with one use by the help of diagram. Like here we take the quantity, like they should be of equal distance 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And here on OX we take the quantity, and OY axis we take the marginal utility and price, and this is 20, this is the marginal utility of money, this is constant, and the marginal utility of ice cream goes on falling. So at the fourth unit it becomes equal to the marginal utility of money. So here the consumer is in equilibrium. So consumer is in equilibrium when the marginal utility of the fourth unit is equal to the price. Now we are going to cover the second situation, single commodity with several uses. When he distributes different units of the commodity in different uses, because he is having single commodity, he is allocating in different uses in such a way that he gets marginal utility from each use. Marginal utility of A use, marginal utility of B use, marginal utility of C use, and so on. Like here he is having 5 liters of oil which could be used in stove and which could be used in larder. So he is a rational consumer, he will compare the marginal utility of oil in stove with the larder. In the first liter he will be using in the stove because he is getting marginal utility 12, and here it is getting 10. So here his first liter he will be using in the stove, and the second liter he will be using in the larder, and the third unit he will be using stove, and the fourth unit in the larder, and the fifth unit in the stove. Here he is going to use the 3 liters in the stove and the 2 liters in the larder. The last unit which he is using in the stove gives the marginal utility of 8. The last which is going to the larder, that also gives the utility of 8. So marginal utility of oil in stove is equal to 8, and the marginal utility of oil in the larder of the second unit is equal to 8. So he is going to use the 3 liters in the stove and the 2 liters in the larder. In this way he is going to drive the total utility, which is maximum, and the consumer is in equilibrium. Now we could also understand with the help of diagram. Here this is O and this is X. This is X dash. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 units. Here also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 units. And here we are taking the marginal utility. So he is using 3 liters oil in the stove, and the second liter he is getting the second in the larder. He is driving the utility 8. Like in this manner we are going to draw. This is 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 and 12, 1, 2, and 3. And here 10, 1, and 2. Because the last letter which is using in the Latin gives the marginal root of 8, and the last letter which is using in the stove, that also gives the marginal root of 8, so consumer is in equilibrium. Now we are going to do the several commodities. Consumer compares, consumer is a rational, he compares the marginal utility per rupee of each commodity in order to reach the position of equilibrium. The consumer will be in equilibrium when the last unit of money he spent on A commodity, the last unit of money he spent on B commodity, and the last unit he spent on C commodity gives him the equal marginal utility. We could also write in this manner: marginal utility of A divided by price of A, marginal utility of B divided by price of B, marginal utility of C divided by price of C. And we could also write the marginal utility of commodity, which is equal to marginal utility of B commodity, which is equal to marginal utility of money. Now we are going to understand with the help of table. Like here he is having limited income, like he is having rupees 5 in his pocket which he want to spend on X and Y. So he is a rational consumer. He will compare the marginal utility of X with the Y. So 1 rupee he is going to spend here, and the second rupee on the Y, and third rupee on the X, and the fourth rupee here, and the fifth rupee here. 3 rupees is going to spend on X and 2 rupees on the Y. Because the last rupee which he spent on the Y commodity gives him the marginal utility of 8, and the last rupee which he spent on the X, that gives him the marginal utility of 8. So they are equal and the consumer is in equilibrium. So here we are going to understand this with the help of diagram. So this diagram is very easy. Like this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. This is X commodity and this is Y commodity. So here we will write 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So here in this manner, this is the marginal utility of X and this is the marginal utility of Y. So here we are going to 2, 4, 6, like in this manner 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, they should be of equal distance, and in the similar manner here. So at the third unit, the marginal utility of X and the marginal utility of Y becomes equal. So here the consumer is going to get the maximum satisfaction, and he will be in the equilibrium, because the last rupee which he spent on X and the last rupee which he spent upon Y, that gives him the equal marginal utility. This law has been criticized by many economists. Consumer is not always rational. We never compare. When we go to the market, sometimes we purchase on the impulsive, and it is not possible to measure the utility. Marginal utility of money does not remain constant, as we are going to have less units of money. So the marginal utility of money remains, money becomes more, and it cannot be estimated in all the conditions. And the utility of every commodity is not independent, because it is based on so many unrealistic assumptions, like cardinal measurement of utility. The utility which we derive from the X is not influenced by the utility which we derive from the Y commodity. So taste, habits, consumers, they are constant. So it is based on unrealistic assumption. It does not explain the price effect between the income effect and the substitution effect. It also does not explain given goods. In certain the inferior goods, the demand curve has a positive slope, so it does not explain.